My name is Santiago Calatrava. I am architect and engineer, and we are here in my place in New York, close to my studio, my American studio. I have also another office in Zurich, where I basically has been working the last more than 30 years, and we have also another small branch office in Doha, Qatar, because we are involved in an important project there. I started in an art school, isn't it? I wanted to do art and draw and painting and sculpture. Then I decided, after a short period of time in the school, to switch into architecture. And then I complete the studies as an architect. Then after that, I study also civil engineering or structural engineering at the Polytechnicum in Zurich, Switzerland. If you look, you know, what means the word architecture, particularly in the history of architecture, is something enormous abstract. It's probably from all the arts, and I deeply consider architecture as an art, the most abstract of all of them, simply because it nourishes itself from all the disciplines. So architecture has not been painting, you know, can be enormous influence by painting. Look at the Sistine Chapel, it's all about painting, or La Cappella degli Scrovegni, which is all about painting, isn't it? Or not being a sculptor can be also enormous enriched by sculpture. Think on some of the Gothic cathedrals, you know, with all those facades and all those beautiful shapes, and so on. You know, architecture is also has to do with social science, has to do also with even with pure technical aspects, you see, of the life, like transportation, you know, movement, airports, you know, aeroplanes who are landing, people who are arriving, stations, and all of that. So, but still, you see, I always consider the architecture as an art, like painting, sculpting, dance, or music, or whatever. And I, like I say, probably the most difficult to reach in terms of the preparation you need in order to deliver something who is coherent. I never conceive an station, you know, as a city product. I think this is as a particular they are in terms of the functional belongings, you know, who are almost the same, you see, from station to station, but all of them are very, very different. So related to the place, and the same thing happens with the bridges and so on. I have done also education buildings, also museums, but you have right, you know, almost 90% of my work is public. And I enjoy it also, I have to say. I like working for public authority. I think it is, that is public, you know, it means belongs to everybody, you know, and I like that. It's true that the major part of the projects I have projected, you know, I have done, they are rather challenging, isn't it? Challenging from the material and from the technical point of view. Challenging and innovative. I always thought, you know, that it's almost a sin to repeat yourself, you understand? It's so the things, you know, you have to take advantage of every circumstance, you see, to deliver for these people and for this circumstance the very best and the newest you can deliver. Now, working from country to country, it does not mean working with the same technological capacity of the construction companies who are involved. And of course, I understand there is a big challenge, you see. Now, there are countries like the United States of America, you see, made appear in a certain, under a certain optic, you see, that they are very conservative, but art is the place where I have done probably the most innovative structures. Sometimes submitted in places in which you see the capacity of the place is not as high, and more than that, even the will of the construction companies, you know, to follow you and to bring their best, you understand, and to shape them, you know, in order to accept the challenge is not there. They are just simply working for profit or they are, you see, accustomed to other standards and they don't want to move into an extraordinary standard. And this is something who happened, you know, after 30 years of work, you see in more than 17 countries, you know, it happens to you that once you get confronted, you know, in such a circumstance. It was, if I look back, it was very risky, you see, and I was very lucky. because I understand that the way, the path of the competition, you know, is a very daring one, you see. So with all your enthusiasm, you are 30, 31, 32, you know, you go in your first competition and you do your first competition, isn't it? And then you are disappointed, you do not win it. Then you do your second competition with a lot of enthusiasm, and then you also don't win it. And if you do your third competition and you don't win it, then you are a little bit, you know, let's say, in a position that you may maybe not go anymore for a competition, isn't it? But I found a lot of support by my colleagues. You see, the first commissions I received by sides of the competition was maybe to do a small balcony, to do a canopy, to work with another colleague, you know, helping him, you know, to do some roofs. This is a very peculiar way, you know, how I started my very first job, until, because I have done a balcony in a very special place called to the old station of Stadelhof, and they invited me, you see, to work in the competition. And you know, competition needs to be, and this is what I think even today, a matter of precision. You see, so you have to deliver the answer, you understand, to the right problem. So it's very important to think about the problem and deliver an answer to the problem. And maybe the fact of being also an engineer has helped me, you know, very much in the beginning, because my mind was structured also strongly, you know, after the rigorous way of thinking of an engineer, which I keep doing today.